What's up, guys? It's Beegs. First off, I want to say I hope you guys all had a wonderful Christmas and a happy holiday. Mine was actually pretty damn good, so I hope your guys' was kind of similar, at least. Now, I don't want this video to be so long, so I guess we should just jump right into it. Now, this video is going to revolve all around a question I've been asked so much. I mean, it's probably one of the questions I've been asked the most on stream and off stream in my Discord. By the way, you should join that. Hail of Blades versus Lethal Tempo. Which is the better rune for Kai'Sa? So how this is going to work is I'm going to go over the pros and cons of both runes, then give you my opinion on the both of them, and the final verdict on which is better and when at the end of the video. I mean, if you want a quick, straightforward answer right now, it's going to be Hail of Blades 90% of the time. But Lethal Tempo is definitely a game changer in some of your games. First, I'm going to start off with Hail of Blades. This rune has been the go-to Kai'Sa rune for a really, really long time now, and there's a good reason for it. The whole rune revolves around three quick auto attacks, which is actually perfect for Kai'Sa, in early game especially, as she wants to stack three stacks of her plasma passive and then W for maximum burst and trading potential anyway. This rune is insanely good for a laning phase because it's literally three quick autos. It's one of the premier trading runes in the game. This rune also goes amazing with all-in and engaged supports like Leona, Nautilus, Pantheon, as you want to burst people down with those supports as fast as possible rather than doing consistent DPS. You want to make the most of their CC in a small amount of time. This rune also makes all-inning with R in the mid-game feel a lot smoother and bursty because three quick autos and then full combo, you know, you just blow them up immediately. As for the downsides of Hail, there aren't that many, like, to be honest. The cooldown for the rune is kind of long. 12 seconds is definitely no short amount of time, especially in League of Legends, but it's not so long to the point that it makes the rune bad. And as a rune, Hail of Blades kind of falls off towards the later stages of the game. Now we're going to go ahead and move on to the contender, Lethal Tempo. Lethal Tempo has a really good level 1 all-in potential. As your attack speed ramps up and doesn't fall off as long as you're actively attacking somebody, seriously, Kai'Sa's level 1 with this rune is like, it's more insane than normal, it's actually crazy. This rune also goes insanely good with the on-hit builds, which are currently kind of meta on Kai'Sa right now. The attack speed from the build allows you to stack Lethal Tempo super duper quickly. This rune is also really good against tanks and bruiser comps, as you want consistent DPS as opposed to burst against tanks. Burst against tanks is bad, right? You can't burst a tank. The more attack speed against tanks, the better. Lethal Tempo as a rune scales great into late game, as it only becomes better as the game goes on considering you can break the attack speed limit at max stacks. Now we're going to go ahead and move on to the downsides of Lethal Tempo just like we do with Hail of Blades. This rune is not good in quick trades in lane. It's not similar to Hail of Blades, you can't get 3 quick autos out in lane. You have to constantly auto attack to be stacking this rune so your attack speed ramps up and you get maximum potential from it. This rune is also only like super great and gets maximum potential with enchanters like Lulu and Nami. Unlike Hail of Blades, you don't get 3 quick autos out, therefore you can't stack your plasma passive up to 3 stacks immediately for the W burst combo in early game. And this rune kind of takes long to ramp up, therefore it's kind of bad in the squishy comps. You don't want to be constantly like having to hit a squishy champ, you want to kill them like as fast as possible, right? Which means Lethal Tempo as a consistent DPS rune isn't very good against those champs. Now that we got the pros and the cons out of the way of each rune, which is the better rune for Kai'Sa? It's going to go to Hail of Blades like every single time. Hail of Blades is literally such a perfect fit for Kai'Sa, it's not even funny. I feel like this rune was like kind of made for her with her passive. It makes her laning phase better, which is her toughest stage of the game, so anything to make it easier is going to be her way to go. It goes insanely good with her passive considering you need 3 stacks for W to explode anyway. Hail of Blades is like especially good against champs like Jhin with an attack speed limiter, as you'll get like 3 quick autos out by the time he even gets 1, right? Overall, this rune is just too bread and butter for Kai'Sa, and you can genuinely get away with taking it every single game if you want to. And now, you may ask the big question, Beagle, when the hell do I take Lethal Tempo then? I got your answer right here. I feel that Lethal Tempo gets its most potential with an enchanter support like Lulu or Nami, as they buff your auto attacks, and even attack speed in some cases, which is the whole shtick of Lethal Tempo, right? The whole purpose of the rune is to auto attack constantly and get it to max stacks and become a kiting monster. Not only is Lethal Tempo really, really good with enchanter supports, this is your go-to rune against tanky, beefy comps. You know, champs that tend to run at you like Darius, Sejuani, Fiora, Ornn, Renekton. You get the idea. You want to kite these guys, right? That's where Lethal Tempo really shines. As I've already stated before in this video, burst against tanks is obviously terrible, so consistent DPS is where it's at to try to take them down. Which is literally exactly what Lethal Tempo as a rune is, right? you're able to stack it really, really easily against tanks, as the whole job for a tank is, you know, stand in front of people and tank damage, so they're always there to let you stack your lethal tempo up. Essentially, the longer a fight goes on, the better lethal gets. So, I hope that I helped clear up a little bit of confusion around the Rune War for Kai'Sa. At the end of the day, it's literally all personal preference. If you like lethal more than Hail of Blades, that's perfectly fine. Take what you want, right? Just know that Hail of Blades is the most optimal rune for her 90% of the time, and you can genuinely get away with taking it every game if you are comfortable with lethal tempo. That's all for this video, guys. Thank you guys so much for the support, and I'm blown away. I already have 1k subs. I don't know. I have no words other than thank you so much. Like, actually. So, I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace. If you gave me a chance, I would take it. It's a shot in the dark, but I'll make it.